It's time for Disney World. Yay!
Our bags are packed. And we're ready to go.
Yay!
Yes, it's 7:11 in the morning. And there's our arrival time in Disney World. Way better than last time. Right?
Oh, yeah.
South of the border,
and oh, you can. I missed the exit.
Oh, darn.
I mean, back up, we missed it. Sign says.
Yeah, it does say that. Oh, well. Guess we'll do it next time. I'm down. Don't believe us, this place is a madhouse. Good morning from Bay Lake Tower. This is our first day in Disney World. Yay! I'm so excited. We're about to bring you along with us to go to the Magic Kingdom, so come along. So as you can see, we have a great view of the Magic Kingdom from our room. We only got to get one night here. We reserved this room specifically so we could go to the Magic Kingdom the next day. We are staying at Old Key West for the rest of our week, and this is just gonna be so much fun. But Bay Lake Tower last night, the view was so spectacular. You should check that out. Oh my gosh. However, this morning, we thought we were gonna get to sleep in a little bit. Lies. I got boarding group 5 for Tron. So we have to get in there. We have to be there by 9:45. They are very, like, much about the time, right? Yeah, they're making you be there for the time. You have to. So we're gonna get over to Magic Kingdom and we'll have you join us when we get there, okay? So Michelle and I are walking our way over to the Magic Kingdom. If you didn't know, there is a path from the Contemporary Resort straight to Magic Kingdom, has its own security line, everything you need. And considering the fact that we have 25 minutes before they call our boarding group, yeah. And monorail! So all you have to do to find that walkway is look for this sign right here across the street. Make sure you look both ways before crossing, and walkway to the Magic Kingdom off this way. And as you can see, there's already a bunch of people on it. You can see the buses, you can see the bus depot, which is over there, and then the private security station, which is just a little bit up the way. And as you can see, security is receding in the distance. Literally just walked through it. There was no one in line, nothing. Had nothing that we had to stop for. Walked right through. That never happens.
No.
Yeah, walking through that security checkpoint is how you do Disney. It's so much faster to go through that checkpoint than it is any other checkpoint here on property. As you can see also, there's a couple minivans pulling up. If you want door-to-door service, we actually recommend the minivans. They are expensive. Here's another one. Door-to-door service.
One of the things I like about security that I wish they had done a lot sooner is the dedicated stroller lines. It's the people who bring all of the things, and you know, it's just much easier that way. They have their own line, they're separated from everybody else, so all their bags and stuff go through separately. I think wheelchairs and scooters too, but it's helped speed things up quite a bit.
All right, Big tip. You see how long this line appears to be to get into the parks? Go around it, go left. You will get in faster. Also, if you're an annual pass holder like us, look for the annual pass holder line, which is usually found in the middle booth right over there. And there we go. We made it in. Ticketing took a little longer than it should have. Just a little tip. You still need park reservations until January. Just pointing that out. You ready? Here it comes. The best view of the day. It comes around the bend. Still looks so pretty. I love it. Now we need to get to Tomorrowland, to Tron. If you haven't figured it out, it is a madhouse in Magic Kingdom when it first opens just after 9, because everyone thinks, a lot of people don't realize that they can be here before 9 to start. And so they all kind of get here, start shooting to be here at 9, and then it starts getting really, really crowded at the entrance. We have 5 minutes to make it to Tomorrowland over to Tron, and I think we're gonna make it just fine. We're probably gonna make it under the wire because we took the through the hub path. If you don't know what that is, you can kind of see how clear it is in comparison to how packed Main Street just was. And we're heading over into Tomorrowland, heading back behind Space Mountain to Tron. And we literally made it at 9:45 to Tron Light Cycle Run. We're gonna head in. I cannot film on the ride currently, so I will have to take my camera and put it away. But here we go. Tron Light Cycle Run. Woohoo! Just for the record, 12 minutes is still within the grace period. But there isn't a long one for Tron because they don't want people trying to come back at like nighttime when they have one in the morning. So they're not really giving a grace period at all. So, but we were 12 minutes. We did get here at 9:45, but it was 12 minutes to get from the entrance to the lightning lane to the actual tap point. So 12 minutes is, seems to be within the grace period.
Tron Light Cycle Run is a thrilling high-speed roller coaster type ride in the dark. Users be warned. Users, prepare to be digitized into the world of Tron.
Locker time, here we go. Hello, stuff. Okay, so that was awesome.
Yeah, it was.
We asked nicely, always ask nicely, be nice to cast members, to sit front row, and we got pretty much right on once we got through the line. The line did take a little bit. It took us about 45 minutes to get from the tap-in point to the ride itself. But now we're heading out. Oh my gosh, that ride is so much fun. So much fun. The ride vehicle, I was worried about it because I'm really tall, that I wasn't gonna fit. It wasn't a problem at all. Michelle, do you feel you were comfortable in the ride vehicle?
Yeah, it's no problem. There's been a lot of hype about people not fitting, or fitting comfortably for a bunch of reasons, but fine for me.
Yeah, it was fine. I enjoyed the ride. The ride itself is short, but it's exciting the entire time. Wouldn't you say that?
Yeah.
So, it's really noisy out here, so we're gonna do the best we can, but, yeah, that was great. I will definitely ride that again. And seriously, front row. Front row is the way to go. Yeah?
Yeah.
All right. Oh, off to Space Mountain for our first Genie Plus of the day. And now we have walked onto Space Mountain using our lightning lane. One of the things you should always ask the cast members is whether or not there is a second touch point, because if there is, you have to wait to tap that one in order to try to find your next lightning lane. So make sure you're paying attention, you ask that question. It's really simple, just say, hey, is there a second touch point? They'll say yes or no. Sometimes the rides have one, sometimes the rides don't, and it's not specific to the rides. Space Mountain, check. Pretty much walk on for us.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're standing in line. We're in the middle of trying to pick our next lightning lane when a cast member comes up and realizes there's only two of us and goes, "Hey, I need two." So we cut the line and I had a quick scramble to put all my stuff away because there's no handhelds on the, ooh, look at the lighting. There's no handhelds on Space Mountain. Little thing. I'm a relatively in shape, despite overweight, older person. I am probably lucky that I didn't hurt my back in that seat. I got put in the last seat. Every single hill, I got thrown up into the air and then hit the back of the chair because it was also coming up. So as you went over all those hills, it was kind of like an interesting little thing. So the thing that I would recommend is if you have a bad back, definitely avoid the last seat, definitely. And now for Michelle's favorite part of the day,
coffee.
So we're here at Revive, which is the Joffrey's cart in Tomorrowland. And we don't often come here for Michelle because she actually prefers Starbucks, but if they have the Nitro Cold Brew, that makes her day because that's what she actually likes, but she says it's not always here. I always get the mango iced tea, but I asked them to only do two pumps of mango because otherwise it's way too sweet for me. Today we're also gonna get some of these lovely pastries that they have on display in the window. They do have all kinds of things from regular donuts to a Pride Month donut to other kinds of sweet treats. I see an apple fritter and cookies in there. So again, the Joffrey's cart right here, it's right outside of Space Mountain because you see, we just came off of that ride, Space Mountain right there. We actually came out over there and we're heading over here to Joffrey's to get some coffee. So I like these new Joffrey's cups. They're pretty cool. They have all of them Mary Blair art around them. That is new, I've not seen those before. These are my mango iced teas. The one thing I tell people about this iced tea is that get less pumps. I always say that, I think I said that earlier. And I also have an apple fritter here, but I got two. This one's for chugging, that one's for sipping. So I'm gonna point out that it is relatively busy today. I haven't really looked at wait times because Michelle and I are kind of doing the lightning lane thing today, but they are definitely long lines hanging out the doors, like Buzz Lightyear, 65 minutes over there. So it's a little busy today. Mondays are a difficult day to come to Magic Kingdom sometimes. But we're gonna make our way to Adventureland because we have a Pirates of the Caribbean lightning lane. And as you can see, we have made it. We kind of took our secret way where we go through the Tomorrowland Terrace. We decided to make our way over to Adventureland quickly because the Festival of Fantasy Noon Parade is starting soon and we would have been cut off from being able to go there from where we were. So, off we go to Pirates. I have a Carousel of Douglas PSA. My largest pet peeve in the parks is when somebody stops dead in the middle of the walking path and just turns around. There are probably people behind you. Please be mindful. Goodness gracious. I just want to point out that the end of line cast member is right there for Pirates of the Caribbean. The line is already outside. I am so glad that we got this lightning lane.
Is that not true, my chromatic winged beast?
Drink up, me heart, yo ho. Yo ho, yo ho, hearts of
the Pirates of the Caribbean, always a fun time. Now, apparently, Michelle and I have a sign on us today that says, "Hey, you're a party of two," because we, yet again, we're standing in line, we're way back. All of a sudden, the cast member goes, "Hey, party of two, come with me." Like, didn't ask, just goes, "Party of two." So we must have a sign on us somewhere that says party of two. But we got right on the ride, sat row two in the ride. Not my favorite row in the ride. I usually like the front or the back. If I'm gonna film, I like to be in the back so that way I don't interrupt people's enjoyment with my screen. But in general, Pirates of the Caribbean, we always say, if you don't ride Pirates of the Caribbean, you weren't in Magic Kingdom. It's quintessential Disney dark ride. We're going to figure out what to do next. I think we're going to do some shopping here in the Pirates of the Caribbean store. Michelle saw some pins she likes, and we saw some great ears. So we're going to do some shopping, and then we're going to move on with our day. As you can hear, we're at the entrance to Festival of Fantasy, right when it comes in, and we kind of are catching the floats as they come out, and it's really cool, and it's a lot of fun. I like this music. This parade music is a lot of fun. Look at that. I'm seeing cast members keeping people from going in. That's why the line's empty. Darn. Big Thunder is down, and I was excited too. While we're here disappointed that Big Thunder is down, it's going to point out all this construction scaffolding around formerly Splash Mountain, soon to be Tiana's Bayou Adventure. So they are full swing in that. They're trying to get that ready for 2024. I'm hoping that they're able to keep this timetable way better than they did with Tron, but as you can see, they're working on it. So Michelle and I got our meals here at Columbia Harbor House. By the way, the only thing I'm really going to talk about, because everything else is normal, it's chicken fingers and some breaded fish and some breaded shrimp, and Michelle just got chicken fingers and fries. Very typical Disney meal. But these are hush puppies, and hush puppies are so good. Now, the other thing that I want to talk about is this space. You see that staircase right over there? That leads to the upstairs at Columbia Harbor House. And not many people know that this exists. And as you can see, it's relatively empty up here. But downstairs is packed full of people. So there's our tip of the day, is Columbia Harbor House. Come up the stairs. They're right inside the door. The one thing I want to talk about with Columbia Harbor House are hush puppies. These things are so good. Love them. They're like a sweet cornbread and just done in a real Southern style. So good. It has been years since I've had these hush puppies. I love them. Michelle and I have finished at Columbia Harbor House. We've made our way through the castle and Fantasyland and are back over towards Main Street USA. For right now, I want to show you something because I'm actually about to use it. I'm having a little trouble with my heel. And right here to the left of Crystal Palace, in that little inlet that was over there I was just pointing at, that is where actually where the first aid station is. I'm actually going to go in there and see if I can get them to get me some ibuprofen. Usually they have like small samples or just a quick, you just need a quick dose and you don't need much else. They'll throw you something. And then Michelle and I are going to go shopping on Main Street. And the smile. Like I said, in this little inlet between Crystal Palace and Casey's Corner to my left is the First Aid and Baby Care Center. Also in the baby care centers, you don't know about this, is that you can also pick up feminine hygiene products. They also carry those here too. They'll let you pick them up, either purchase them or they may have some samples that they have available. Mission accomplished. They gave me a dose for now and a dose for later of ibuprofen. And one of my points that I like to tell people about when you come here is please make sure that you have your shoes broken in and you're used to wearing them. I'm not gonna embarrass them because they were in the first aid center right after I was done, but someone in the first aid center did not pay attention to that simple rule and their ankles were all torn up when they walked in. And he's like, yeah, these are new shoes. And I'm like,
He was in a lot of pain.
As Michelle just said, I don't know if you heard her, but he was in a lot of pain. You could tell. Always break in your shoes before coming to Disney. Big tip. But if you have problems, go to the First Aid Center. They will help you. Situated on beautiful Main Street, USA, we are inside the Emporium. It looks from the outside to be one shop after another, but what it really is one big continuous place that makes Michelle happy. And the store goes from the top of Main Street to the bottom, all along the left-hand side if you're facing the castle, and has pretty much everything you want. It's the next largest store in Disney to the World of Disney store. So, and Michelle constantly finds things that we definitely don't need but are going to buy. Up the Lily Bell, very nice. But the Lily Bell train is up there wishing us hello. We just walked out of the Emporium here on Main Street. Right over there is the barbershop. Make sure you stay tuned to the channel because I have my first ever haircut at the barbershop. I'm very excited about that. Michelle and I are now walking over to guest relations because we need to update our annual passes and get the new version so that we can make sure to get our discounts and things because they like you to have whatever the new ticket is all the time. But guest relations, you don't know. Thank you, Lily, is right here to the right after you walk out of the Emporium. So this is the guest relations main space. What you will do is you'll come in through this door and you'll wait until they call you over and then you can take care of whatever you need. They do all kinds of things. They have the celebration buttons. They'll deal with annual passes. They'll deal with problems with your account, all kinds of stuff. And the cast members are always very friendly as long as you are nice to them. Be nice to them because they have nothing to do with what's going wrong, but they can solve it and they will solve it faster if you're nice. Now, unlike the Emporium side of the street, you will find on the opposite side, the confectionery and all the other shops appear to be joined together. In actuality, they are not. But the confectionery here has all kinds of things. It's got different color M&Ms and all kinds of sweets and snacks and candied apples and just pretty much everything you could possibly want. And it's really nice to look through. We actually rarely buy stuff here because all of it is very, very, very decadent and excellent. But this is the confectionery, which does connect onto the ear shop, currently the Disney 100 shop. But then that's about the extent of the connection because you have to leave the store to go into the next room. And if you're looking for that special Disney 100 merchandise, it is in this section, which is the old cinema shop. And they have all the Disney 100 merchandise. They're kind of, right now they're kind of focusing on Mickey Mouse, but they have been focusing on all different kinds of things of the aspects of the 100 celebration. I think this shirt, Ringer shirt, is actually really cool. But if you're checking out some of the Disney 100 merchandise, this is where you will find it. One Disney tip. I'm standing in the cinema shop, and above me is the vent for the best air conditioning in Disney. It just pumps right here. If you really need to cool off quick, I'm like, right now. Because it has not been all that hot in Pennsylvania so far, and it's 90 degrees and humid today in Florida, which isn't all that bad for Florida. But if you ever want to cool off quick, right here at the one, underneath the one vent by the ear wall in the Disney 100 shop, that's where you should go. In the world of, if you ever all want to get me a gift, this $49,500 crystal-coated castle would look great on my dining room table. By the way, you can get this in the Arribas Brothers, which is the crystal shop. They also do like custom engraving, and they make custom pieces right there in front of you, and they do a fabulous job. All of this stuff is really fabulous. There is currently on display in the front window this $100,000 crystal castle designed by Miguel Arribas himself, which is a very impressive thing. However, of all the pieces, if you really wanted to get me something nice, this castle would be perfect. I mean, it's only $250,000, coated in crystals, handcrafted, just stunning. This would look fabulous on a coffee table. In fact, it would probably be the entire coffee table, but this is an absolutely beautiful piece. One of the last things in Arribas Brothers I think is pretty cool is this glass blowing shop where they actually make glass blown art, which you can see on display over here, like on this large Christmas tree and in display in the window with these bowls and jars and glasses. They actually do full displays of how to do this glass blowing art, and it's actually really fascinating to watch. And the ovens are on, which means that they're probably doing the glass blowing today, which is pretty awesome. Real quick, while we're waiting in line for coffee, we found out that they have sold 3 of those $250,000 castles, and there's 50 of them ready to go. They did tell me, though, that that smaller one, they've sold 44, and there's only 50 of those. So if you really want to get me one, time's limited. We have avoided the parade, had to take a strange route back around Sleepy Hollow Refreshments, and we're heading over here to the Haunted Mansion. We have lightning lanes for this. The current wait time is 50 minutes. Michelle and I, this is one of our personal favorites. We almost always ride Haunted Mansion, sometimes twice. There's a really good photo opportunity when you get off from it too, which we recommend. We will probably show you that picture right now. It's straight ahead. You can kind of see the PhotoPass person. She's over here. But the opportunity is really cool. They usually have some extra magic, makes you ask for it. But lightning lane for this ride so that we can get right on. Disney fun fact, this hearse is an actual hearse, not a reproduction, a used hearse. Brings more authenticity to the Haunted Mansion. Thanks for visiting, Leota.
Goblins and ghoulies from last Halloween, awaken the spirits with your tambourine.
Close your eyes and don't try to hide
for a silly spook sit by your side.
They have selected you, you belong.
To remember death certificate. If you decide to join us.
Don't have to say much. Haunted Mansion. Fantastic. Disney Imagineering at its finest. Just love it. Michelle and I finished with Haunted Mansion, which, by the way, is now up to a 60-minute wait. It's 50 before we got on it. We just passed the end of the line right before we got to the riverboat. And now we're heading down to our lightning lane for Big Thunder Mountain. And the Festival of Fantasy Parade is finished. So it hadn't started before we got on. Now it's passed after we've gotten off. So it's a kind of a nice way to avoid that kind of rush to rides afterwards, is to ride when the parade happens, see the 12 o'clock parade, and then the 3 o'clock parade that everyone kind of sticks around for, because that's kind of like the moment when they might take their kids back to the hotel, and they use the parade as a way to do that, how to get them out of the park. Oh, look, the parade happened. Let's go back to the hotel. So the park starts to empty a little bit at 3 o'clock for about 2 to 3 hours. So you have a window where a lot of the ride times are going to go down because of that. And here we are in Frontierland, heading to Big Thunder Mountain. We do have lightning lanes for this, but it currently has a 40-minute wait. That's not too bad. That's a decent wait for Big Thunder, and this ride is worth 40 minutes. So I have to put my camera away because Big Thunder Mountain has a new rule about no handhelds, just like Space Mountain and a couple of others now, which is fine. But for right now, we're gonna go ride Big Thunder, the wildest ride in the wilderness. Big Thunder. Always a big fun, a lot of time, a lot of fun. The main thing, hey, there it goes. The main thing about Big Thunder you have to know is that it is a little bumpy, so if you do have a little trouble with, like, maybe your back or whatever, to be careful. Michelle and I have discovered recently that we love the back of the train. The back of the train is way more fun for us. It's a little bit smoother and you enjoy the ride. You have a little bit more of the whole overall experience. So, back row, Big Thunder. Now, we don't know what we're gonna do. We did get Jungle Cruise originally for $8.50, and I fiddle-faddled it until it switched over to $6.45. So I do have Jungle Cruise coming up later, but we don't have anything between now and then except for our dinner at the plaza, so we may just hang out. Michelle and I have made our way over to the Plaza restaurant. We have checked in for our dinner. We are looking forward to it. If you'd like to take a look at the menu for right now, here are the appetizers and entrees. I will also put it up on the screen so you can see that with their prices. We haven't eaten here in a long time. And the reason we haven't eaten here in a long time is because, well, to be honest, we had a really bad experience twice in a row with ultra dry chicken sandwiches and all kinds of other things and bad service. However, that being said, we are here at the Plaza restaurant to give it another shot. We are very glad to have you along with us for it because, hey, we are the kinds of people who want the food to improve and everything here at Disney to be great. And we, I've heard good things about the Plaza restaurant, and so we're giving another shot. We have been seated, and we are in the process of picking out our food. They've given us the menu. They do have a regular menu, and they did have a special today of a pot roast open-faced sandwich, which sounded great, but I think it's too heavy for me. That sounded good, though. And they do have a beverage menu, which I'm going to grab. Sorry to steal it from you. Michelle already said that she liked the way the sangria sounds. And, of course, they have milkshakes, which come from the Plaza ice cream. So, lots of good choices here. Remember, you can only get cocktails and beer and wine at sit-down restaurants in Magic Kingdom. It's just kind of a thing that they do, so don't be surprised about that. Are you ready?
Michelle got the sangria that we were talking about. It has Indaba Sauvignon Blanc with pineapple juice, spice, and fruit.
Okay.
And the verdict? She likes it. The thumbs up. The Michelle patented thumbs up of approval. These are the Plaza French fries. We've already tried them. Bacon, got a really nice spicy sour cream and cheese sauce and scallions, and just, I like them. I think that they have a really good flavor, and they're using the standard thin cut Disney fry, but in general though, the combination of all those flavors is really, really nice. So that I really like.
So Michelle got herself the Plaza burger, and her side, she chose her side of grapes and apples, and I'm actually kind of jealous because those look good. They look fresh. The Plaza burger has bacon, garlic aioli, cheese, lettuce, tomato, and it looks very tasty. I got the Plaza Reuben, but I made a substitution. I had them put the cabbage from the fried chicken sandwich on there, and I got green beans as my side instead of fries because we had the Plaza fries. But both of these look very tasty. I also picked up a Cigar City High Lie 16-ounce beer. I wish we had this in 16-ounce back where I live. We only get it in 12s, but that's okay. It's a very good, very light, refreshing beer. I've already had it, so I don't even need to try it. So I recommend the High Lie beer from Cigar City. It's very good. It is kind of national, but I'm looking forward to pairing it with this sandwich. First off, I'm not going to interrupt their meal, but I'm going to thank the family to my right for the lens wipes. Thank you very much for the lens wipes that they gave me. I got something on my glasses, and I couldn't fix it, and they gave me a lens wipe, and it made me so much happier. Now, about the dessert. They're awesome, and now about the dessert. This is my chocolate and strawberry milkshake with whipped cream and a cherry. And now Michelle got a cookies and cream sundae with hot fudge, whipped cream, and a cherry. And if you didn't know, the Plaza restaurant is connected to Plaza Ice Cream next door, so they get all their ice cream from there, and it's hand scooped, and it's really good and tasty. So I've been looking forward to this milkshake. So I'm not 100% certain, but I'm pretty sure that we'll come back to Plaza. We haven't, like I said, we haven't been here in years, but today's meal was completely consistent. Everything we had was excellent. Plaza restaurant, it's a pleasant surprise. And for the money, I'm actually not bothered at all. Now we do get the annual pass discount, which is higher right now because for the time we're here, they're giving a special bonus discount. But for the price, we're actually getting really, really good food. We're actually pretty much eating for about under $100. Can't really beat that. So, especially in Disney, because it's tough. And we know how Disney prices can really affect you. Anyway, we're gonna head off into the parks, probably go find something else to do. We have a Buzz Lightyear Lightning Lane coming up next, so we're probably gonna head to that. On our way into Tomorrowland again, as you can see, the sun is at our backs. We've had some nice interactions with some great cast members. Shout out to Jose, the photographer. He took these photos. Had a lot of fun with those. But now we're heading on our way to Buzz Lightyear Space Ranger Spin. We won't spin too much because we just ate. I think that makes Michelle happy. She just went, yep. So we're gonna get on Buzz Lightyear Space Ranger Spin because we have a lightning lane. And then we're going to head over to our other lightning lane at Jungle Cruise. A good showing. Look at that, 822, 300, 140 for Michelle. We tried really, really hard. Yeah, thanks, Buzz. And I am a cosmic commando. All right, my Carousel Douglas friends, I need you to do me a favor and tell Michelle in the comments down below how her score wasn't bad. She is not as bad as this game as she thinks. Sometimes it's the game, because those targets are old and they need a refurbishment. In fact, I would love it if we would switch over to the Astro Blasters style, where you could have the gun in your hand and it's not attached to the ship. That's the one in Disneyland, for those of you who don't know. I think that one's a lot better. However, I do still like Buzz Lightyear. And I want to point out that our lightning lane helped us skip this gigantic line. So, lightning lane's definitely very helpful today. We're gonna head to Jungle Cruise. We were able to sneak one in, and I was able to fiddle faddle it earlier. But we're heading to Jungle Cruise. We are doing kind of across the park a lot today, and that's okay. It's our first day, and we really want to make sure we get in everything of our favorites, because we've missed this place. I am really glad that the 50 statues are still here. Here is Tinkerbell, and hopefully I can get the reaction. I do want to point out this very hidden one. This is Abu, and Abu is hidden on this Adventureland post, and every time I walk underneath it, I would get tapped and go, all right, where is the statue, and never realized he was up high. So there's Abu. As you can see, we've made it to Jungle Cruise after crossing over the hub and playing with the statues, and it is at a 70-minute wait, but we have lightning lanes.
Welcome to World Famous Jungle Cruise, where we are famous around the world for being, you guessed it, world famous. My name is... Sadie, I'm going to be your skipper, your tour guide, your dance instructor, your lion tamer, your snake charmer, your Jedi master, but most importantly, if you don't laugh at my jokes, it's going to be a long 10 or 12 minutes. And much like any family, I should give you some advice. This advice came to me from my parents on my 18th birthday. They said, Skipper Sadie, sweetheart. I said, yes, Skipper Mom, yes, Skipper Dad. It's a family name. They said, Skipper Sadie, sweetheart, we love you, we do, but most importantly, free rides over, get out.
Cast members make that ride. Yeah?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
She was great.
She was great. Skipper Sadie, hopefully I was able to pick up her jokes. She had some new ones that I hadn't heard before. I love the Jungle Cruise. And if you have a good skipper, it makes it all the better. I have ridden Jungle Cruise probably 100 times. And if you get a bad skipper, it ruins the ride. But if you get a good skipper, it's like it's your first time on the ride. I love it. I love that. Sadie, great job. So Michelle and I are making our way through Liberty Square to head up to Fantasyland because It's a Small World has a 10-minute wait. And while I'm not going to get a lightning lane for that ride ever, I love that ride. Michelle does not. So the wait has to be really low for her to be willing to get on it. And it's low. So we're getting on it.
Time and air conditioning.
Yeah, there you go. It's time and air conditioning.
It's weird.
You win this round. Don't get to get on Small World. That line is not 10 minutes. It's not even 20 minutes. The sign switched over to 20 minutes as we walked up, and I walked up to the cast member and was like, it's not even 20 minutes. It goes longer. Yeah. I love Small World. I actually do love it. Not worth that line. Heading over to Little Mermaid. That's where we decided to move our lightning lane to. Starts in 2 minutes. Michelle loves this ride. I do want to point out that the last time we were in Magic Kingdom, Michelle and Sammy got a broken clamshell. It's really funny. Here it is right here.
Stay seated in your clamshell while I do the bottom of this.
Yeah, let's get to the bottom of this. We should not be facing each other right now.
I think we're the ones in the wrong.
You are, because everyone else is facing that way. Well, hi.
Hi.
You broke the...
I'm green, good news.
Yeah, I was laughing way too hard at that. That was a lot of fun, but we're going to get on. By the way, Michelle and I chose to pay for Genie Plus today. It was expensive, but there's only two of us. I can see why a family would have a problem with this, because Genie Plus today was $25 a person. So a family of four, now they're out $100. We're just out 50. I can't see that being worth it to anybody with a family larger than us. That price is just through the roof. I really wish they'd do something about it, but Universal's Fast Pass, their version of the Fast Pass, the Express Pass, is way more expensive than that. So, I don't know.
The top, the See for yourself, poor child.
They weren't kidding when they called me Baba Witch.
There you go, you got to see your Little Mermaid.
Without a broken clamshell this time.
Yeah, without a broken clamshell. That was really kind of funny. The main thing about that ride is that the animatronics are kind of creepy sometimes. Ariel doesn't blink in one moment, and yeah. Oh, look, crepuscular rays from the sun. There, you learned a new word today. The main thing about that ride is it tells a really good job with the story, and we really do enjoy being able to, you know, ride that because Michelle's favorite movie growing up, right? You were terrified of Ursula, though, weren't you?
No.
No? I thought you were.
No.
Oh, well, I guess she's...
Wicked Witch.
Oh, it was the Wicked Witch. That's right. I knew there was...
Wrong villain.
Yes, wrong villain. Right. Yes, the Wicked Witch. The Wicked Witch is what scared. I knew she hid from something. And then we're going to do what we like to do at the end of the night is get to our fireworks spot and just chill out. So once we get to our fireworks spot, we'll come back and join you, and then we'll talk about how happily ever after and how glad we are to see it again. So we're going to head over to the hub and our favorite spot, and then watch fireworks. Come along with us. Real quick, I went over to Casey's. We are in our favorite spot. I don't have my good microphone hooked up, so I apologize for the audio quality, but we're in our favorite spot, and I also picked up one of these mint juleps from Casey's. I'll tell you, I'm not the biggest fan of mint flavor. However, I love mint lemonade and like basil lemonade. If you've never had a basil lemonade, you need to try it. That weird combination is so good. But this mint julep lemonade is really, really good. I recommend it. Get them from Casey's. It's a great way to spend your time as you wait for fireworks in your favorite spot. A great night. We've had a lot of fun. Happily ever after. So good. So good. Especially when Tinkerbell flies, right? Favorite part. Did you cry?
Always.
Your shirt said you did. Anyway, we've had a great day in Magic Kingdom. Please make sure you keep following after all of our adventures here in Disney World. And please, if you enjoyed this vlog, which we'd really appreciate you watching and sharing, comment down below, what was your favorite part of our day today? What's something you would have done differently? Anything would help. And remember, we don't like to say goodbye because we're going to see you real soon. So we say, see you, bye.